Hi everyone. Just trying to put this here so I can see it. Hello? So let's see. Just checking if so you can see me, right? Hi. Hi. So I'm now seeing the comments. So hello everyone. I am super happy to be here with you. Thank you so much for the invitation. I am Sofia Fox from Portugal. I am an architect, a cake teacher, and the owner of Sofia Fox Cake Art Studio. Hi Marta. Happy New Year! today I am the owner of Sofia Fox Cake Art Studio, that is a school of pastry and cake design here in Portugal. Today I'm going to show you guys how to do this wafer paper or sheets, okay? Just waiting a little so people can enter, and then I'm going to turn the camera down, okay? If I don't see your comments, don't worry, after the demo I go to each one and answer you all of your questions, okay? So ask wherever you want, okay? So I think I'm going to start now. I'm going, hola Karina. Karina is one of my Portuguese students. I'm going to turn the camera, okay? So I can start, okay? Can you see? It's good like this? Yes? Okay. Oh, you are also kind. So, I want to talk you a little about the kind of wafer paper that I usually use. I like to use a wafer paper that is really thinner, okay? So, to make wafer paper flowers, it's really important so that you use a good quality wafer paper. Something like this that has a shine and is really flexible, okay? That ones that we use to print, they are not good to make flowers, okay? So something like this with the little of texture and this shine, I think it's really beautiful. I'm using at this moment, this one is from Saracino, I think so. And I'm going to explain you a little how I do it, how I transfer the drawings. Usually what I do is I do it in computer. I'm going to give this to the group, okay, after the demo. Usually in the computer I draw the shapes of the flowers. You can do it by hand. You can do it something like this and you just draw it by hand. I do it on the computer because like I am an architect, I'm usually accustomed to programs, to drawing programs. But you can just easily use a cutter for flowers and then design the shape, okay? And use that for this kind of work. Also, in the wafer paper, you always have something that has a texture. And the other part, it's smooth, okay? I always like to use the part that has the texture because the texture is going to make our flower more natural because the flowers have texture, okay? So for me, it's important to use always the part that has the texture. And then I'm just going to explain you, I just have cut it before the class, before the demo. The flower, but I'm going to explain it how I cut it how I do it to be faster. So I'm going with a pencil drawing over the design that I have here. Okay, and I design the shape like you can see there. Yes, and then with a scissor I cut it like this, a stripe. And then imagine I want to do a lot of flowers. Okay, so I continue cutting other stripes for all the flowers that I want to do. And I could continue. I don't want to, because I'm just going to demoing how I do it. But I could continue cutting the stripes. So then I cut like this, okay? And I have the shape. And because in our mold, in our design, it says front and back, and then says two petals each. This means that I'm going to cut one front and one back, and in the middle I'm going to put a wire. Okay? Are the wafer paper rice? No. Wafer paper is one thing and rice paper is another, okay? Rice paper is like that, I don't know the name, but is the, what it's the ones that we have in the supermarket to eat. They are round, okay? This is wafer paper, not rice paper, okay? And it's different to work with one and with another. Hi, Cristina! So, like I was talking, I have one front and one back. So, that means that I'm going to put a wire between the two, okay? And that also means that I'm going to put the front with the texture for me and the back with the texture for each part. So, the texture is always... The smooth part is always under and the texture is okay. So just to explain, this is the texture part and I'm going to put this to me, and then this has a texture part, I'm going to put this to you. So I have texture and texture and smooth, okay? It's really important, because if you cut it like this, you cut the back and the front at the same time. You don't have to cut one and then go and cut another, okay? And then when I cut it, I always put the pencil part. I cut the pencil part so I can't see the pencil in the petal, okay? Like this. Do you see? Now I have texture and I have texture, okay? And between the two, I'm going to put a wire and glue them, okay? This is what we are going to do for all this and all of this, okay? This one doesn't have a wire. We just glue it one with one, okay? Here I have the flower cut it. Here I have all the petals already cut it. And then what I'm going to do is just, I have, and let me tell you, I'm going to need three of these. Two of these and one of these, okay? So, let's see here. so I can see the comments there. So I have one with back in front, you see it? Two with back in front, and three with back in front. For this, I just have one with back in front, okay? Hello everyone, hello to all that is entering now. Here I have one with back in front and another with back in front, okay? So the first thing I'm going to do is wire the petals, okay? I'm going to put the wire so they can just dry a little. I have the wires here cut. Don't worry, because after the demo, I put this on the group and I tell you the size of the wires that you need, okay? If you don't understand really well here, okay? So like this, and this one. First, I'm going to put a wire in this one, this and this, okay? This, I don't need a wire. These wires are wires of thickness 28, okay? You can use 28 or 30, okay? We want wires really thinner. And we can use this kind of wires because the waffle paper is really don't have a weight, so we can use it. And I'm going to use a pencil like this, okay? I like to use a fluffy pencil, and this is just a cup with water. I know a lot of people use piping gel, a mixed of waffle paper with water, glycerin. I just use water, okay? Is the kind of work I like to do. And for that, I just separate my petals. I have here the front and there the back. In the smooth part of the petal, I'm going to put water in my brush. Just tap a little here so I don't put a lot of water here. Then go with the water. Just a little, okay? When it's good, it's when you put your finger and your finger glue it, okay? Then I pick in one of my wires until the middle of the petal. And just picking this one with the texture to me and glue it. You don't need to put water also in this one. Just water in the one that is lying down here, okay? And then you have to press it really well in this part that you have the wire, okay? You see the wire? Okay, is till here. Till the middle. You have to press it really well because we don't want that the wire moves. We want that the wire is glued to this part and to this part. So I'm going to do exactly the same to this one, just with water, okay? Don't put too much water. It's better if you go and put water step by step. Because if you put a lot of water, you can mess up the leaves. You can mess up the leaves because the water can melt the waffle paper, okay? So be careful with that. Hello. Kisses to Argentina. So, like this, okay? So, these two are wired. I'm going to do the same to these ones. And in this, you please pay attention that the part that is upper, is this one, and the part that has the wire, it's in here. So I'm just going to separate them in the smooth part of the petal. Water, then my wire till the middle of the petal, or a little more upper. Glue the other part and then press it. And another thing that is really good to work with waffle paper is if you don't glue it really precisely, don't worry, you just can pick on your scissor and then correct the shape again so that the two parts are precisely, okay, like this. So just going to do the same to these two, always in the smooth part, okay, always, not a lot of water, just a little of water, the wire, then I glue the other part, and then I press it really well. Okay. And the last one of this. In the smooth part, I just put the water. Glue the wire. And then put the other over. And then press it really well. Okay? Hello, Patricia! Okay, like this. So I have three like this, two like this, and this one, I'm just going to glue it together, okay? So in the smooth part, water, and then I glue the other part over. You already know, if you don't glue it really well, don't worry, you just can pick in your scissor and cut the shape again. Okay, like this. So the first part is done for one flower. Now I'm going to use, you can use or you can't use it, you it's your choice. I like to use always a veiner, okay? This is a veiner for this kind of orchid. And this is for the tree, and this is for this two, okay? And for this, I don't use water, I use vodka, okay? Alcohol, something that is a white drink that doesn't have any color, okay? So I'm just going to clean my brush so I can use it with the vodka. Here I have vodka, okay? And then I'm just going to pick one side, put my pencil in the vodka, and just in one side I put vodka there, put this in my veiner, and I press it a little, just in one side, okay? You can do it in the two sides, but if you do it, if you put vodka in both sides, you need to let the petal here to dry, okay? Because I just put it in one side, I can take my petal now and let it dry here, okay? Because it's not so soaked in drink, okay? Alternative to vodka, something with alcohol volume, okay, with a lot of alcohol. I don't know, here in Portugal we have something that we call alcohol cereal. I don't know if you have there. That's a good alternative, okay? So, like this. I have the shape, you see? Okay. And then I let it dry. So I'm going to do the same to the other. Just pick one side. Also, there is a mixture with glycerin that I think you can also use it. The petal is going to be a little more flexible, but it's also an alternative, okay? So, like this, and let it dry. Now I'm going to do the same with this one. Okay, vodka one side, put here in my vinyl, and then don't press it too much. Okay, be gentle in this part because you can make wrecks on the waffle paper, and you don't want to do that, so just gently. Press so it has the shape you see, and then just let it dry. The same to the other two. Just press it. Gently, okay. I'm just making this part first because this needs to dry before I can paint it, okay? So always do this part first. Then, after this, I'm going to make the center. And when I'm making the center and one of the buttons, this dries, okay? So I can start painting. So like this. Really important, don't put over, okay? Always put it like this in a surface that doesn't has any paper, okay? Just go put this one a little more. Like this. In this one, we are just going to do this. With a scissor, we are going to cut till here, okay? Till this point, like this. Yeah. And then with your fingers, like this, put the here and then here. So that is starting to do something like this, okay? So you can have the right shape. Just gentle with your fingers. You help to roll this a little. So you see, we start having the right shape. So this is going to dry. And now I'm going to show you how to do one button, okay? And the center of the flower, okay? This part here. Just a little of just a little of sugar paste. It's really, really, really called here in Portugal. So our sugar paste is really hard. Okay, just mixing a little, and then I'm going to use CMC Tylo, okay, to do the center and one button. So for the center, I'm going to need a little ball like this, okay? I think this has half centimeter or 4 millimeters, okay? And for the button, something like 1 centimeter. You don't need to do it all. You don't need to do it all with the same size, okay? Do it once bigger and once smaller, so it's more realistic. So thank you, Tanuta. So this one for my button and this one for my center. Really, really, really small ball. And now I'm going to use my CMC, and I have here 2 wires, this and this. Whoa. This one. This has 12 centimeters and is a wire with the 20, okay? It's a 20 wire. And this one is a 24 wire, okay? So the 24 is for the button, and the 20 size is for the center of our orchid, okay? So for this, and because we want to fix really well the center, we are just going to pick in our tool, and then here, and then just roll it like this and squeeze a little, okay? Like this. And I'm going to do exactly the same to this one that is more thinner, okay? Like this for my button. So this one that is for the center, I'm going to put just a little of CMC. Usually I press it a little here on the CMC and then I mix it. Just for the Tylo is just for the sugar paste to dry faster, okay? If you want, you can do the buttons and the centers in the day before, and start doing our flower in the day after. Also, these kind of flowers are awesome for countries that have a lot of humidity, because wafer paper is really good with humidity. So it's a good alternative. Just going to press here a little like this and like this, so they don't roll too much. Like I was telling, the wafer paper is really good for countries with a lot of humidity, because we don't have the same problem that we have with the flour paste, okay? So it's something that you can consider it, and it makes really beautiful flowers, so it's a good alternative. So I have the Tylo with the sugar paste here. It's normal sugar paste. I'm using a Portuguese sugar paste that is past color, okay? So it's not a flour paste, it's a normal sugar paste like fondant. And then I put a little of Tylo. I roll a ball here with a little one, and then press it in one side, okay? So you can have a shape like this. Then with glue or just a little of water, okay, I put the wire there, and then I'm going to press it in the thinner part so I can glue it to my wire. And this part is really important You need to pinch, okay? Really pinch. Like this. And then I pinch and I take the excess off. Like this, okay? So that my sugar paste is really glued to my wire. So I have this shape. And then with my finger, I do it like this. Okay. And I have this shape. Okay. Hi, Katya. So my first one is done. This is for the center. Okay. I'm just going to let it dry a little, and I'm going to show you how I do the button. So this one has a 1 centimeter. It's a ball of 1 centimeter, and then I'm going to put just a little of Tylo, like I did for the center, and smooth all together. Really well. Now I'm going to make a ball, okay, to take off all the wrinkles. And then I'm going to press in one part and do like an egg shape, okay? Rebecca, I'm going to put the template after the demo, okay? Like an egg shape, okay? Like this. And then I put glue it to my here in in this part that is bigger, okay, like this. And then I'm going to do the same, pinch the sugar paste to the wire, and starting to correct the shape again, like this, and take the excess off, okay. I always do like this. You see, I have sugar paste here, and I'm going to press it and start taking all the excess that I don't need it. So this part comes off, and you see it's really good. And now that I have my shape here, I'm going with the something like this, okay? This is a CerArt tool. I'm going to do like a crust, like this, and like this, and like this, and like this, okay? So I usually put this on my hand, and I start from the bottom to for like this, you see. I think you can see it. And then I go all around to the other part. Picking in the part that I stayed, I go here and I do it. So it's like a stripe all around. And now I'm going to do the same in the other direction, okay? So like this, I define a crest, you see, and then I go down, and in the other direction I also go down. And you see, I have something like this, a shape. Okay. So, and I let it dry a little. Just put this here. Don't need this anymore. My petals are drying. Do you see? What is starting to happen? They start to roll it, because it's the drink that we put it, the water and the vodka, it starts to roll it. So now I'm going to glue this part to my center, okay? For this, I define the place I'm going to show you first. So do you see I cut till here to this part, and then I'm going to make a hole in here, okay, in the center, like this. I'm going to, with the wire, make a hole, okay, and then this comes to stay like this. You see it there? Now I'm going to put water here so I can glue these two together. Okay, so let's do that. With a little of water, I put the water here in this part and the part of the center in the back. And then with my finger, I press it so they can glue it. And in this point, you need to stay a little here, okay? Because the sugar paste and the waffle paper need a little more time to glue together. So just have your finger here pressing all together so they can glue it. And we have it. You see? It's glued there. Okay? Like this. So I put this aside. And then just waiting to see if my petals are. Just need to wait just a little more in this part. So I'm going to make all my center when I wait for this to dry, okay? So for the center, it's almost done. I just need to do a little one thing, that is to do two little balls here, okay? So with sugar paste, a ball really really small, like 2 or 3 millimeters, like this. I do the ball and then I do like a small roll. You see it there? And I'm going to glue it here. With a little of water, I put the water there. In this part here, okay? And then I glue the roll there. First step, like this. Okay? And then with the same tool that I use, this one that has this part, I'm going to define two parts, okay? I'm going to make a stripe here in the middle. And I'm going to shape so I can have like one ball one side and one ball the other side. If you want, you can just do two little balls and glue the two balls, okay? Is like it's more easy for you, just do it. You see? Like this, okay? And then when I paint, this is all white now, but when I paint it, you are going to see so much better. Now this part is ready for painting. I'm going to start painting this before, and then I paint all the rest. I have here my colors that I'm going to need, then I can make a list to you, okay, if, of the colors that I used. I usually use the magic colors. And then I'm going to use small brushes like these ones, okay? And something like this. These are from CeraArt, are these ones, okay? Because I like to paint with the brushes that are good to paint with powders, okay? I usually always paint with powders. I I give a lot of classes of painting cakes, and this is the kind of brushes that I like to use. So now I'm going to start painting. This part you can, I mean, what we are doing here, it's the base. After this you can paint wherever you want. You can just look at one washi that you like and paint it, okay? I'm going to paint one similar to this one. That was the one that I have been inspired to do. So, for the painting part, and so I don't mess up here my workplace, I'm going to put just a little of kitchen paper and I'm going to start painting. I'm going to use a yellow color, okay, just powder. I'm using this one from Magic Colors and the others are just powders like this. I'm going to put my brush here in the color, take the excess off in the kitchen paper, and then I'm just going to paint the part of the balls that we have done now and a little more down. Just going to show you the shape like this, okay? So here in the buttons and then a little more down. Okay, this is with yellow and with like a peony rose, a color really strong like this one, you see it. I take the excess of here and I'm just going to paint in the beginning of the part of the upper part of my center like this, and then I'm going to mix a little of vodka here in the same color, and I'm going to paint with the color but in a liquid form all of this here, okay? So with something like this I'm going to put just a little of vodka. I always like to use this kind of recipients because it's better. I can control the quantity that I put in my color, in my powder. So here is also vodka. And then I'm going to mix the color so that the color stays in a liquid form, and with this I'm going to paint all around the part that is not the yellow, and okay, and then all the rest is in this pink just here in the middle. You see, like this, I paint all. Here is white and I just paint in this part. Don't paint over the yellow, go around the yellow. You see, like this, and I'm going to do exactly the same to this part. We want a really intense color, okay? So paint all of it. Don't paint over the yellow. And little more intense here. here. Really intense color, okay? So you can go over again like this, okay? This is the center. Now, with a small brush like this one and using vodka in my chocolate, my brown powder, I'm going to mix the color and do in the part that is yellow, do some balls, some points, okay? Just little points. Like this. Can you see it there? And now, because this is smooth of the liquid, I start to just helping the shape. You see? And you have the shape done. Okay, so this is our center and we put it here. You see, it's exactly like that one here. Then we are going to paint the button, okay? This one. I'm going to pick two more pencils, one for my green and this one for my pink. So in the bottom I'm going to use three colors for these ones. It's like I'm going to use a dark green here, a lighter green here, and then a pink here. It's like the flower, it's starting to grow and I can start seeing the color of the flower that is going to grow. I'm not using gel colors, I'm using powder colors, these ones, okay? And when I want to put it liquid, I use vodka over. So, I'm going to use lighter pink, like this one, here. And just in the bottom, I paint just the bottom, like this, okay? And then after this color, I'm going to use a green that has a little of yellow. I'm going to show you better the colors, you see? So I have here yellow, this is the green that has a little of yellow, this is the dark green, this is light green, and then the pinks that we are using. So using that one, I painted with the pink till here, and in the middle from the pink to here I'm going to paint with this green, yellow green, okay? Just like this. Because we want to do it like the colors are blended, okay? Like this. And then to finish, I'm going to pick in the darker green. And then I'm going to paint it from the bottom, from the end upper. Blending really well all the colors. The two greens blending really well. Okay, so I always put the pencil here and then I smooth it. And we have something like this. Okay, you can see it with my light. You think it's really bright? Is that? I'm going to. I'm just going to turn the lights a little. So if you can see it better, just like this. It's better? Yeah? Tell me something. Uma, you told me that was too much light. Can you just see if you can see it better? Yes? So, now I have my center done and I have my button. Okay? I'm going to start to painting the leaves. All here. Also, I'm going to show you something that sometimes I like to do in some flowers to some flowers to have a more intensify veiner effect. So sometimes I use like a tool like this. A needle, and then I just put the needle here in the beginning, and I start doing little lines, just really smooth. I don't press it, okay? It's just smooth, so I can intensify the veiner effect, okay? Like this. It's not visible when this is white, but when we paint it, it's more. The powder goes to the stripes that we do with this, and it's more intense the natural effect of the flower. So I just put it here, and then I go like this, and like this, and like this. You see? All this from the bottom, doing stripes like this. I'm doing this in this flower because the orchid has veiners that we can see it really well. So I'm just trying to intensify this effect a little more. Okay, just doing the same to all of them. Gentle, okay. Don't do it really like this, okay? Just really gentle. And when I'm going to paint, when I paint, this is going to show a lot more. So now I'm going to start painting my leaves. For that, I'm going to use just two colors, three colors. I'm going to use this green. I'm going to use this peony pink, really intense, and a little of this baby pink. Okay? So, first step, I just pick in my green, in my light green, take the excess off here, and I'm going to paint from this part and down all the leaf. Okay? I want to give it a little of color. And why do I start painting in the limit? Because I want it to be more intense here in the limit and more smooth. I don't know if you can see it. Like this. And then all the same in the back. Okay? We paint the two parts like this. Just going to do the same to the others. It's a really light green, okay? So we don't want, when we do flowers, we don't want to do a color. We want to blend really well the colors, okay? So we need to start painting really smooth, and then if we want, and if the flower is with a color more intense, then we start intensify the colors. But I always like to start painting really smooth and then go intensifying more and more and more. Okay. With the green, okay, and then I'm going to do exactly the same from this bottom to the entire, okay. Yes, yes, I'm going to give you the list of the colors, okay, that I have used.
Don't worry.
After the class, I put a PDF of this drawing and the list of materials, okay, that I use, so you can do it yourself. And then please, if you do it, tag me. I would love to see, okay? And then in the other part, okay, always paint the two parts of the flower, the back and the front, like this. It's a really light color. So one side and then the other side. Okay, like this. Then we change to the peony pink, that really intense color. And with this color, we are just going to paint in the center of the petal, okay? It's like if the color started to appear here and then smooth it to the green, just like this. I start painting here. And then I try to blend really smooth to the green part. Like this, okay? Just the beginning and then really smooth to the green. And do the same in the back. Like this. I'm going to do this to all. I will do the same in these ones, just in the beginning of the petal. It's just like the petal, when the petal is born from the center, the color starts and then it transforms in this beautiful green color. So the most important here is to blend really well the two colors, okay? Doing the same. And if you didn't work with waffle paper until now, I think you are going to love it, because I think it's easier to work. I love flowers in flower paste. They are beautiful, but I think working with waffle paper, it's more easy, and it's not it's more easy, and we don't have the problem of the weather of our country, because waffle paper is more resistant to the humidity than the flower paste. Ok, And you see, I'm doing exactly the same to all of them. Just in the beginning, and then smooth it really well to the green part. We do the same in the back. And you see, I always go there to the color, go here in the kitchen paper because I want to take all the excess, and then when I start painting here, the color is just going to blend so much better with my other color, the green color. And the last one. Olá, Piedade! Sorry, I just said to my Portuguese friend, olá, hello, in Portuguese. And then in the back. Okay, really smooth. Be gentle. Like this. Okay, you see? So, we just need to do one more thing to this petals, because if you see it in the original drawing, they have a little lines, and some are straight lines and some are with points. So I'm going to do this, I'm going to reproduce this in my petals. For that, I'm going to use a small brush, and I'm going to use this pink, this bright pink, and put a little of vodka in the color, okay? You can use also accents. Like lemon essence or extract, I think you say extract. Something that don't has color, but you can use it instead of the vodka, okay? I like to use alcohol, vodka, or something like this, because it dries faster, you know? So it's just because of that, I prefer something with a good quality of alcohol. So now I'm going just to do stripes, and I'm going to start in the middle and I do a continuous stripe here. And then I'm going to do a stripe with points. And I'm going to alternate this, so I have a straight line, I have a line with points, I have a straight line, I have a line with points, I have a straight line, and then I do some lines here. You see, or if you can see it, something like this, okay. And I'm going to do the same to the other part. Here with point. Here straight line. And is this kind of work that makes your flowers become more realistic. The painting is really important. If you can if you can see all the details and all the things that the real flowers have and transmit it to your cakes and to our flowers, it's going to become so more realistic. Like this. And then I'm going to make all around a line with points. Okay? All around with points. I am just trying to represent that flower that I was inspired, okay? You can paint like you want, or like the flower that you see and want to reproduce. So, okay, like this. Consegues? Baixa mais a câmera. I'm going to try to put the camera a little more down, if you can. Like this, okay? Hope that you can see a little better. Try to make this here. So, you see the lines there? I'm going to do exactly the same to the other ones. Straight line in the middle. Like this. And then aligning points. Straight line. Aligning points. And so go on and on till we finish the painting. The same to this side. Like this. And just doing lines, okay? This is the part that we take a little longer, but at the end, when you put the flower together, it makes a really realistic work, okay? So these details sometimes are really important for you to have a good finished work, you see, like this. So these tools are ready. I'm going to do the same in here. The lines I'm just doing in the front part, not in the back, okay? Just the lines. I painted in the back, in the front, but the lines I just do in the front of the flower, because the flower that I see, it was like that, okay? And with this work that I'm going that I am showing, you can do the orchid that you prefer, because you have white orchids, you have purple orchids, you have blue orchids. So use it like you prefer, and I hope it help you to start making flowers in waffle paper. Just doing the stripes, one straight, one midpoint, and then doing the point line all around the petal. Just two more. I will upload it to the group, okay? When I finish the live, I will upload it my drawing to the group, and the colors that I have used. So if you want to do something like this, you can do it. So point, straight line, point, straight line. Okay, all around the same, like this. Okay, and then the last one. Sorry, but I have to. I have minimized the lights, but here in Portugal it's really dark outside, so I have to have light so you can see just. You can see me, but I think now you can see a little more the colors. And we are almost finishing that part of the painting. Just doing the stripes. One straight, one midpoint, one straight, one midpoint. Okay. And then one midpoint all around the limit of the petal. And we are done. The painting is done. Okay? So now we can put together our flower. So I'm just going to put this aside. Put my wires here and then my leaves. Two of these, three of these, and one center. I'm going to put the button here. Okay? So for putting together my flower, just opening a little more of the center. You see, it's almost dry, like this. And to put it together, I'm going to use a green flower tape, okay? Half of the I have already cut, just half of the flower tape. Cut it like this. Okay? I'm just going to stretch and see where she glues. She glues in this part, so it's the part that I'm going to use. And I'm going to explain you how we can put it all together. These leaves, these ones, we are going to turn like this. And like this, you see, to become like this. I'm just going to. It's better so you can see me better here, okay? So, like this, I'm going to put this here. One is going to the upper part. And I'm going to show you. I'm going to turn to you. So, like this, when it's going to the upper part, I'm going just to do this to the flower. Like this. Like this. Just a little. And then with my fingers to stay in this shape. Okay? This is going upper. These two, we are going to. Put the wire like this. Okay, so one stays here and the other exactly the same. The wire goes like this and stays here. Okay, we can start seeing the shape. And in the center, I have my button. Okay, my center of the flower. So now I can start putting all together. Just picking on my center and start putting one of these here. Like this. Okay, you see it's in that part, in the middle. And now I'm put my flower tape here. I usually do it like this. I glue it here and then I pull it till here. For me, it's more easy to do it like this, okay? So, like this. And then I'm going to put the other one. This is like two ears. For me, I always see it like two ears of the flower. You see? One, two. And when I put this, I'm going to, with the flower tape, do two more rounds. Like this one. Just to glue it really well, to make it firm here. You see? Like this. Then I'm going to put this one that is in the upper part like this, and if you can see it in the back, they are all together. You see one here, and this, it's going to, they are going to connect to each other. So two more round, one, two, and three, okay, like this, and like this, you can see it, yes, and then I'm going to put these two, one, here, and it's there, okay, and then the other in the other part, in the other side, so like this, go around, go around, okay, like this, in the back is like this, and then I will do exactly the same to the other one and then go around. One. Gentle. Okay, you see it? And then I'm going to roll it. All around the wire to the bottom. Okay. All around. You see, just going to put it all together like this and like this, okay? So now I'm going to put this all together. I have one, two, three. I'm just going to do a branch of the flowers. I'm going in this one, I'm going to put some flower tape also in the wire of the button. Here I have this part already done and I'm going to show you how you can do this. Just I have here more buttons done and I have a wire of 20 in half, okay, I just cut it a wire of 20 thickness in half, and then I'm just going to put the smaller button in the part like this, you see it? Just like this. I put the wire, the flower tape in the wire there, so they can connect. And then I start putting one to one side and roll, you see, like this, and roll the flower tape, just go down a little and then put the other to the other side, like this. Do the same, you see, always, one, two, one, two, one, two, you see, I'm just doing the repeat thing again, and the other to the other side. And then I roll it to the bottom. Okay, like this. So this has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this has 13. Okay, so now I'm going to put together. This in one wire, okay? Just a little bunch of orchids. For that, I'm going to use a wire of 18. It's the thicker one, so it has a good structure. And then I'm going to start with this in the top, okay? Like this. And I'm going to let me cut it half. Something like this. Just in half. And then I'm going to fix it together. So I put this here and I start rolling. So I fixed this part to my wire. Then I'm going, and for the orchids I always do this, so it's more easier to enter in my range, okay, in my branch. So I pick in my orchid, I pick it there in that part like this, and then I blend it a little like this, you see it there, and then here I blend it like this, so I can have a little, you see. So it's more easy that my flower can enter easily here, because it has some space, so they can stay like this. So first I'm going to put my orchid here and roll the flower tape. Okay, like this. Okay, then I'm going to put another orchid. I have the first here in the center, and then I'm going to do the same with this one. I'm going to do it like this and then do it like this. So I have space, you see, like this. And this one I'm going to put it to this side, so that this can enter here, okay? I'm just going to put my flower tape a little more down so I have space to put the other flower. And I want that the other flower goes there. Okay? So I just need to go a little more down. And then I have this flower here, okay? And with my I roll it to fix it really well. So at this point I have this, okay? So now I'm going to fix these two together with a little more of flower tape. And I'm going to do the same to the flower, like this and like this. You see, because we want that this space between. So I'm going to do something like this and glue it together with the flower tape and then put this in the first range, the first branch that we were doing. Just going to turn this a little to that side and it's going to enter here, just quick. You see, like this. Okay, pretty much. I'm just going to turn the camera upper. So, yes. No, yes. So, just roll it a little more down, and then I'm going to put this here. Okay, at this point. So, and then I roll it. Hi Judith, hi Michaela. And then I roll it down. And then I cut it, the end. We don't need that to be so bigger, we can cut it here. Okay. And then we have it. Okay? So this is what I had for you today. This is the work that we have done. You can repeat a lot of them and then you have it. Sorry, it's too to stay. So, it's the work done. I hope you like it. I'm going to see all your questions. If I didn't answer some question, I will do it now, okay? I'm going to leave in the group this drawing in PDF. And also I'm going to put the material list, the colors that I have used, so you can do it. If you do it something like this, or if you do it a work inspired in something like this, please tag me. I would love to see it. Okay? So, that is for today. I hope you like it. Big kiss to all my beautiful friends that I saw it here. Sorry if I didn't answer you because I was here doing this work. Big kiss and see you in the next time. Okay? Bye-bye.